the desire to sort of understand the world around us is as old as mankind, huh?
This started more than 400 years ago when Galileo first used the telescope.
This is a need of the human being, not the human curiosity.
If you look at the electromagnetic spectrum, on the low energy side, we have infrared and radio waves. On the high energy side, we have X-rays and gamma rays, light with extremely high energy.
Gamma rays show you the most explosive, massive events in the universe. If you want to explore very high energies, you need to do it through gamma rays.
With gamma rays, we can probe fundamental physics. We can look for dark matter.
Well, seeing gamma rays is kind of tough.
We don't see the gamma rays directly.
High-energy gamma rays produce a chunk of light.
Gamma ray runs into the Earth's atmosphere, makes this particle cascade. That's where this chunk of light comes in.
It's really a flash that lasts a few nanoseconds.
Are we trying to capture these Cherenkov flashes with ground-based observatories?
With CTAO, we can study the origin of cosmic rays.
Gamma rays are useful in the sense that you are looking at the highest energies, so the most extreme processes in the universe.
Really a powerful probe of what's going on, sort of at the frontiers in terms of this energy range that we know so far.
The final question is, how can we do all this?
From the very beginning, the idea was we want to see the full sky, and that means we need two sites. The north side will be on La Palma, and the southern side will be in Chile, the world's two best astronomical sites.
CTAO has a tremendous energy range. We span many orders of magnitude in energy. We make use of different sizes of telescopes.
We deploy three types of telescopes.
Each of them is optimized for a specific energy range.
A large size telescope. They measure low-energy gamma rays. This has a diameter of 23 meters.
That's because the flash of Cherenkov light produced by very low-energy gamma rays is a very weak flash of light.
200 mirrors, around 100 tons.
Able to point within 20 seconds to any position in the sky.
We need very special cameras.
Very precise optics.
The camera is fascinating, 2.5 by 2.5 meters and weighs 2 tons.
An exposure time of a nanosecond, which is a million times faster than any normal camera. You sort of take 1 billion pictures per second.
The main part of the observatory are the medium-sized telescopes.
They have 12-meter diameter. They're devoted to study the intermediate range of energies.
The kind of core energy range of CTAO around a tera-electron volt.
The SST is the smallest telescope. We only have in the south for scientific reasons.
The highest energy gamma rays produce a lot of Cherenkov light, so we have relatively modest size telescopes. We need a huge collection area.
Spectacular distribution of telescope.
And the other big part is software.
There's no way you can save all that data. So the trick is really to recognize in real time if there's something which looks interesting.
It's a lot of data, so we're talking about petabytes per year.
It's quite a bit.
Where we are now, we have advanced prototypes of all the elements.
We have a prototype LST on La Palma, on the northern side.
It is so beautiful.
There are many telescopes to construct. This is the start of the game. It's not a minor challenge.
There are still quite some hurdles to be taken.
One of the big challenges is just the scale.
1,400 people. There's a lot of varied expertise. There's nothing you can build on a national scale.
It's like having an array of telescopes, but then you have an array of scientists, and that makes the whole image more complete.
10 years, I say, more than 10 years. We started the design study.
There is many things that we expect to see. I think the most interesting would be the things that we are not expecting to see, you know, the unexpected.
We have to admit, you know, we don't know what most of the universe is made of. We have no idea.
You end up discovering something you were not even foreseeing.
In the end, the great discoveries were never, rarely ever, what was written in the proposal.